Voilà, il y a quelques années, sur le pont des Arts, j'avais rencontré tôt le matin un photographe dont le nom me reviendra et que je citerai, qui faisait des panoramiques du pont Neuf. Et aujourd'hui, je rencontre de nouveau quelqu'un qui travaille avec un bel appareil. Et qui fait des panoramiques. Can you tell me some words about your material?
Sure, this is the camera or the subject?
The camera.
The camera is an Alpa, it's Swiss made. What's happening right now is this lens produces a very large image circle, and so I'm moving the sensor, the digital back to film.
Okay.
Around the image plane.
Okay, you.
And so when it creates a panoramic, yes, they are perfectly together.
Okay.
So a lot of times if you take a camera and you just shoot,
yes,
software has to stitch it together and a lot of warping occurs. But when you have the lens stay the same and the film moves on, the film or the sensor moves instead, they match perfectly. It's a much higher quality panoramic. And I'm just going to do one more to make sure. So I just moved the sensor 18 millimeters. And so now the sensor is right in the plane of the, is right in the middle of the lens circle, the image circle on the lens. Voila. And then I just moved the sensor another 18 millimeters. Check. Wait, it's in focus. There it is.
Okay.
The other thing this camera can do. Oops. There's a screw here, and what that can do, I'll just let you see it here. So if you want to, normally when the film plane is the same as the lens plane, the depth of field, area of focus, is a flat plane. So by tilting the lens plane with respect to the film plane, and you're going to be able to see it right here, you can actually change your depth of field.
Okay.
And so this tilts up to 5 degrees. So you can see now, the lens is tilted this way, and the film is tilted this way. So what that does is it allows you to shape your depth of field to do really interesting compositions. And then these are all the manual controls, that's right. These are all the manual controls. So this is focus, this is in feet. This is your aperture, all the way from f5.6 to f45. You have you cock the shutter here, and then you release it here. So this is all of this is manual. From here to here is manual, and then this is the only digital part. This is a digital sensor.
Okay, what's the cost of an Alpa?
Very expensive. Very expensive. Do you really want to know?
Yes.
Okay. So this entire setup is about $30,000 US. $30,000.
$30,000. Okay.
So the back, this okay. is a phase one digital back. It's 50 megapixels.
Yes.
The back is around $15,000. The camera, so just the camera piece, is around $4,000 to $5,000.
Okay.
the lens is around 7,000. So you add all that up, it's about.
And that's digital.
This is digital, but I could put film here if I wanted.
Yeah. You can put film. Okay.
Yeah. Let me just. I'll show you. Okay. Oh. Come on. Okay.
You remove the back?
Yeah, I'll show you. Mm-hmm. So you just...
Same
two latches here.
Okay. Okay.
So that's the sensor. And you can put film here, you can put a different digital back. They have digital backs that are go as high as 100 megapixels.
Okay.
So you could put a 100 megapixel digital back on it. Voila. C'est fini.
It's very interesting.
Thank you.
The photograph I saw was working on 120, you know the format?
Yes.
120.
I do.
And the picture was 18 centimeters, 6 centimeters by 18 centimeters.
Wow.
I think it's a Fujinon.
Wow. I have an app that actually lets me visualize the what the panoramic's going to look like on this camera.
Yes.
And so that's the shot I just got.
Yeah.
It'll take 3 photos, but that's
okay.
And then I can actually if I change the sensor orientation, I can visualize that as well with this app. So if I that would be a panoramic if I change the sensor orientation from landscape to portrait. And then one frame looks like this. It's a 70 millimeter lens, so one frame would look like that. So there's this app that comes with the camera that lets you visualize these shots before you take them, which is helpful.
Very interesting.
Thank you for your time.
Thank you, don't go away.